first thing you have to do is trim the fat. And this might sound callous, and I don't mean for it to, but I do think you have to look at your staff, look at the people you have. And I hope they're all good hires and they're wonderful people and blah, 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 blah. And that's all good. But I do strongly believe in this thing. And this is something we had to learn the hard way, my husband and I, building four businesses. If you look at someone you have hired who works for you, if you look at them on day 30 of their employment with you and would not hire them again that day, then they probably need to go. And that's hard. You know, we don't want to fire people just willy-nilly. But I know, you know, I say that in the context of my husband and I hired someone because we thought it would work out. We thought they would fit into that role. We thought we could train them enough, and they just didn't. And, you know, after 6 months of being with us, we looked at each other one day, and I said, would you hire him again today? Like, if he came in and interviewed right now, knowing what you know? And he said no. And that was when we realized that that was a bad hire. And the good thing there is that, you know, after we let him go, eventually over time, he came back to us and said the best thing we ever did for him was to let him go because he was able to do what he was supposed to do, right? So I think a bad hire is more expensive than a good hire, obviously. I think a bad hire at a lower hourly rate compared to a good hire at a higher hourly rate is, you know, ends up costing you more money. Absolutely. Which is, again, kind of counterintuitive, but there's a lot of work that goes into hiring people. And so I think first off, look at your staff, your employees, your contractors, and again, and ask yourself, would I hire them again today? If yes, awesome. You've got an investment that's paid off. If not, consider reorganization, and maybe that means letting people go, but hiring the best people you can possibly hire, because any money you spend on them, it won't be a gamble, it won't be an expense even, it will be an investment. So I think that's one piece of it. And I think looking at your systems is that kind of next step. I see a lot of business owners who just send emails, and that's the extent of their email marketing. They don't have a need for a CRM, and they've got something like Entreport or Infusionsoft, and they would be more than, you know, at $300+ a month, and they would be more than taken care of with something like ConvertKit, which is, I don't know, $30 a month or something. You know, things like that, that are just, there's no sense in you having a system that is that robust when your business doesn't have those needs. And CRM is just one example, but I think lots of businesses have things like that. They've got the shiny object because so-and-so said, oh, this is like, you know, the thing you need. This is the BMW of whatever's, and you know, you don't need that. You're fine with like the Honda Civic version of that system or technology or software. Now, of course, that's not the case with everything. You know, some businesses need to spend that money and need to get that better thing. But often just look at what your needs are and then match those up with the thing that will accomplish that, not the, you know, and then some, but the system, the piece of technology, the software that will do that job and doesn't have to go, you know, above and beyond and have extra bells and whistles that you don't need. And then I think that third thing there, you know, is to make sure that you're looking at the goals that you set for your business and make sure they are money making, that they are moving you towards the money, that they're not just about audience building or list building, but they're about getting those people there so that you can ultimately serve and sell them.